everybody. Lance Russell, Dave Brown, right along ringside. Ready to go with another big day, championship wrestling. And son of a gun, we got a lot of matches today, Davey.
I tell you what, we do a bunch of them. Here's some of the folks that are going to be with us today. Steve Kern will be here. The Invader is also on the card. Stan Lane, Robert Gibson will also be looking at beautiful Bobby Eaton, Sweet Brown Sugar. Roy Rogers is on the card. Also, Gypsy Joe, The Monk, and The Angel, all of them coming up on this very championship wrestling.
Boy, we got a bunch of bouts, and we'll get into it in just a second. I do want to add to you that we have an interesting special I think you're going to enjoy about the classic confrontation between the King and the Dutchman a little bit later on. Also, we've got something on Bill Dundee. By golly, we've had some injuries that have occurred in there. Yeah. We'll be talking about those later on. So stay tuned. Big championship wrestling show. We'll get to it in just a moment.
Paul, 15-minute time limit match, introducing from parts unknown, the Invader, and going against him from Florida, Steve Kern. One fall, 15-minute time limit match. Referee is Jerry Calhoun.
Okay, the jacket's coming off, Steve, and we're going to be ready to go right here. That unusual mask the Invader has on. Bell time. I'm just wondering in there, Davey, if he is trying to avoid seeing Kern over there. Because the eyepieces are covered up.
I know, yeah. We have seen him here before one time, and I don't know how he sees, but like I say, maybe he doesn't have to see Steve Kern.
Coming at you. Boy, that's a tough one.
It sure is. They're reversing each other. Steve finally gets him off his feet and just drops him right down to the mat. And Vader back on his feet, though. Steve, nice takedown from around behind him. Invader goes for the ropes. Referee right there wants a break, gets it. Through the ring. Invader, side headlock. Steve rolls him down, shoulders down. One. Count of one is all he gets. See some of that quick Steve Kern action, though.
He whipped that arm into the hammer and was right around into a front face lock on it before you could shake an eyelash.
Invader making good use of the ropes. He forced Steve back to the ropes again. Required a break. Single leg drop by Steve Kern. He drops down on the knee. Minute 20 seconds gone. Opening match. Steve Kern. Ooh. That's the Invader's leg taking that punishment there. Referee checking with the Invader for possible submission, but so far he's hanging in there. He may think better of it, though. A couple more of those.
Yeah,
Steve Kern. Invader again goes for the ropes. Referee Jerry Calhoun tells Steve going to have to break the hold. Steve steps back. Invader on his feet. 2 minutes. The Invader goes for a side headlock. He just powered out of it. Invader could not maintain the hole very long at all. Kern takes him down. Shoulders are down. Count of one. He really didn't have much of his own weight over those shoulders to be able to hold him down there. But when the shoulders were on the mat, referee started to count. Invader to the ropes again.
Rope.
Yeah.
Well, I'll tell you, the Invader has made excellent use, and I am not belittling that because that's a good, smart move by any wrestler who needs it to hop out of trouble. Kern pressing back, center of the ring.
Down to the mat again goes the Invader. And once again, the Invader goes to the ropes, hooks his feet around the bottom rope, and Steve Kern breaks it. Referee steps in between them. We've just passed the 3-minute mark of this match. 15 minutes, the overall time limit on it. Back into the ropes, Steve Kern. Vader getting a little nasty. He body slams Steve, goes for the ropes, drops with the upper arm. Steve is on his feet, and Vader grabs him, whips him across the ring. Steve ducks under, drops him down with a suplex, two. Three. Steve Kern in control of himself all the way. Boy, some good moves throughout the match from Steve Kern. 3:32 the time on it, and the win goes to Steve Kern.
Boy, I got to tell you, Dave, he had not only some good moves, some excellent moves, and that payoff move that he made in there where he converted right. It back into that back suplex as he took him back over. He really dumped him in there nice. And an excellent win. And what was the time again?
It was 3 minutes, 32 seconds.
3:32, and we're about ready to go. We're going to continue, by the way, right straight on with our next bout. It's going to be a tag match. And we got a brand new team that'll be their first time on Championship Wrestling. Davey?
Total weight of 480 pounds from Memphis, Tennessee, Bill Owens, and his partner from Nashville, Tennessee, Ernie Kirkland. Going against him at a total of 444 pounds, from Delray Beach, Florida, Stan Lane, and from Pensacola, Florida, Robert Gibson. This match will be one fall, 15-minute time limit. Jerry Calhoun, the referee.
Seeing a pairing of Robert and Stan Lane here, you got it. And there's the bell, and we're off and running. Rick has been injured. We're going to be talking to Rick a little bit later on. We regret to say that he is unable to wrestle. And Stan and Robert are teaming up, and you know they ought to make a doggone good team, too.
They should. They are both known for their fine moves in the ring. Both of them in great shape. And Stan Lane in there right now, putting a little hurt on Ernie Kirkland.
That's our first look at Ernie, and now Bill Owens, the first time that we have seen Bill in here on Championship Wrestling. And Stan Lane, nice scissor to the leg, took him right straight down. Both Owens, who runs at about 230, and Kirkland, who goes around 250, big guys, stocky. They're not all that tall in terms of being 6'7 or something like that, but I'll tell you what, they are some kind of blocky wrestlers. So Stan and Robert Gibson giving away a little weight, but thus far Stan Lane looking very, very sharp. Standing side headlock, mares Bill Owens over and down.
Stan and Robert both known for fast action, for their speed in the ring. Speed could come in handy if the team decides they're going against.
True. Robert takes tag. He's in, holding on to a side headlock. Back to the corner, Ernie Kirkland takes the tag from Bill Owens, and big Tennessean steps in there against Robert Gibson out of Pensacola, Florida. Stan's out of Florida, too. Delray Beach, so you've got a couple of Florida boys together, and a couple of Tennesseans together, as a matter of fact. Robert hanging on to that toehold as he went down hard on Ernie Kirkland over to the corner. Stan Lane drops on the exchange. And Kirkland being tied up in a knee package with that toehold that Stan stepped over on, moved in. Right to the center of the ring. Catapulted that leg. Boy, he sprung it. And Stan Lane over. No way he could control the shoulders of a big guy like Kirkland at that point, but Stan, a good move by him.
Got him limping a bit on that leg. Sprung open.
We're about 3 minutes into this one fall, 15-minute time limit bout, and Stan Lane scissored the leg, has Kirkland down on the deck. Tag on Robert. Bang. Oh. Right over the top. One, two, three.
Nice teamwork there.
I think he keyed it right from the top, Dave. The speed just a little too much. Kirkland and Owens, a little bit bigger team in terms of total weight. But Stan and Robert, with that excellent speed and some beautiful moves, did it up in good fashion, too.
Yeah, the time on it was 3 minutes, 8 seconds, 3:08.
Yes, sir, and really went all the way with Gibson and Lane together in their excellent, excellent pairing as they came out victorious. We got more action. We're going to be back. We're going to be talking, as a matter of fact, to Rick Gibson about his injury in just a few minutes.
brother. All right.
Channel 3's championship wrestling action. We'll be back into the ring here in just one moment. Do want to take time to tell you about, again, coming up, that's on Tuesday night. The wrestling action will be going right there at the Louisville Gardens, my friend. We'll give you the entire card a little bit later. A couple of matches I want to mention. An AWA Southern Tag title match, which the new champions, beautiful Bobby Eaton and Sweet Brown Sugar, are going to be going against Robert Gibson and Stan Lane. And, of course, the big main event is going to be a one-on-one. Let's settle it right now. The King and the Dutchman going at each other for that AWA title. All of that action plus a lot more coming up right there in the Louisville Gardens Tuesday night.
You know, Russell, I told everybody a couple of weeks ago that there was a new wave in professional wrestling coming, and you're looking at them, Sweet Brown Sugar and beautiful Bobby Eaton with the mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart. You know, everybody has hurt. Poor little Ricky Gibson, he's hurt his little belly. And then you've got Jerry Lawler, he's got cowarditis. And now Dundee's got his shoulders hurt. You know, we're going to probably have to go out in the audience to find somebody for these guys to wrestle. Right, Sugar?
You know, Lance Russell, we told everybody up there, when we step out of the ring, we will be the Southern Tag Team Champion, beautiful Bobby Eaton and myself, and we did it also. So Dundee, Kern, Lawler, just bring it on down, because, hey, beautiful Bobby Eaton and Sweet Brown Sugar, we are ready. Tell them.
Well, you got them won, now you got to keep them.
That's right. I told you once and for all that you finally got some class with some tag team champions around here, and I'm talking about Sweet Brown Sugar and myself. Now, Robert Gibson, we done hurt your brother. We done put him out of action, and then you wouldn't got that Stan Lane, the guy that turned his back on Jimmy and the First Family. Keep bringing on your partners, because you'll never, ever get these belts around your waist. Stan Lane, you just put yourself in a man's position right now, because when I get through with you Tuesday night in Louisville, I'm still going to walk out Sugar myself with these belts. But you might not even walk out there at all, buddy.
Well, we hear it from that side of the fence, but I'll tell you one thing. The whole match is going to be done in the ring Tuesday night in the Garden.
That's right. You know, we back up everything we say, and they're powder puffs. That's all they are. So come on down, boys. We're ready.
Tuesday. To be in the ring with action coming up here in just a moment as we'll be looking at the new Southern Tag Champions, beautiful Bobby Eaton and Sweet Brown Sugar in a moment. Standing right here with a couple of guys we were talking about a moment ago, and that is Rick and Robert Gibson. Robert, by the way, congratulations. Good win. You and Stan looked excellent in there together. Rick, I mentioned during that particular match that it was a strange thing with Robert in there tagging up with Stan Lane. In the fact that you had been injured, and son of a gun, you not only are unable to wrestle today, but I want to know the extent of it. I know the injury was something we were really sad to hear about.
That's right, Lance. The other night, wrestling Coco Ware and Bobby Eaton, Jimmy Hart came off the top rope and hit me in the sternum. Now, if everybody's not familiar with a sternum, it's the bone right here that is between your chest. Well, I went to the doctor, and he run a test on me, and I've got a cracked sternum. Mm-hmm. And the cracked sternum, it's pulled up now.
That's held by what, a cartilage in there?
It's held by the cartilage, and the cartilage is cracked. Uh-huh. And there's swelling behind it, which is pulled out, and there's swelling behind it, and it's pressed up against the heart, the swelling is. And so the doctor advised me not to take any chances. I'm not going to take any chance on wrestling. I'm going to be out of action for a while. I don't know how long. It's a dangerous thing. I get a blow there.
Yeah, I was going to ask you, how is it painful like standing here right now, Rick, or how does it really affect you?
Well, it's very painful. I can't move at a fast movement or anything, and since Monday,
any kind of blow or anything,
blow, and since Monday I've lost 8.5 pounds.
Good.
I can't keep anything on my stomach. I can't eat anything except soup, and it's very painful, but hoping I can get back in action soon.
Well, partner, you know how we feel about the team of the Gibsons, and I had just said, as a matter of fact, doing a match that you all were involved in, that I have never seen you guys looking better together. I never have seen you in better position to get those Southern Tag titles that you are so interested in, and with good reason, too. And then, son of a gun, of course, this is one of the things that happens, but I know for all the wrestling fans, we wish you a lot of good luck and a speedy recovery on that thing, and you're smart. Don't take any chances.
Thanks a lot, Lance. Before I leave, I'd like to say one thing. I'd like to apologize to the people that my name is advertised around the area that I'm going to be at. My name's on the card, but I'm going to be substituted. I'm not going to be there, but I'm going to be back soon.
Okay, Jimmy. Now, don't come in here and start any of this stuff. Hey, listen, get these guys to the ring now. I'm telling you, Jim, we'll suspend you out of this TV. Just get them up in the ring. We're not? Okay, fine. Come on, Sugar.
Don't worry about it, boys. I just wanted to come by and ask y'all one little question, man. I just wanted to say one little thing to you. How in the
world did you call that retarded mother of yours and tell us you were...
Ah, Mark, you are... Robert, don't get... Hey. Okay, Rick, thank you for coming out, and good luck to you in there. We're saddened to hear it, but good luck to you. Okay, Davey, let's go for the action in the ring.
One fall, 15-minute time limit match. Featherweight of 435 pounds from Nashville, Tennessee, Roy Rogers. And from Salem, Virginia, Rick McCord. Going against him, total of 448 pounds. From Huntsville, Alabama, beautiful Bobby Eaton. From Union City, Tennessee, Sweet Brown Sugar. Their manager, Jimmy Hart. The new Southern Tag Team Champion. Yes. This match is not a title match. One fall, 15-minute time limit.
Okay, Bobby, we get the idea. Bobby, just pay attention to what you're up there for. Well, you know, you like to try to give everybody, and we do, their just deserves, and be honest about their wrestling abilities and that stuff. But you get somebody like Hart who comes out and tries to make fun of a situation on Rick and Robert Gibson, and it is very difficult to remain with any kind of objectivity at all. So we are now seeing the young team of McCord and Roy Rogers going against the tag champions in a non-title bout. Beautiful Bobby and Sweet. Yeah, okay, Jimmy. We've heard enough out of you. Just sit down.
Bobby Eaton in here against Roy Rogers. Eaton went to the rope, got a foot outside. Now he heads back to the corner and tags Sweet Brown Sugar, Coco Ware. It's Brown Sugar against Roy Rogers. Jimmy Hart yelling and screaming at everybody. Of the crowd. His wrestlers and their opponents. Ooh, Roy Rogers' head smacked into Bobby Eaton's knee. Brown Sugar with a body slam. Referee trying to get him out.
Brown, look at him. Baby, before you go to school of professional wrestling, look at him. Look at him.
Bobby Eaton pounding away. Brown Sugar, too. Now, I'll tell you one reason he's not looking so good right now. He's been double-teamed for the last minute in there. Brown Sugar. Buggy whips him across the ring into the turnbuckle. Flip out of the corner. Brown Sugar with a knee to the back. Again and again. Brown Sugar back over to the corner and another tag made. Bobby Eaton with a double forearm across the back of Roy Rogers. Roy, near the corner, gets the tag. Rick McCord greeted by Bobby Eaton, and he is rammed across the ring into the knee of Sweet Brown Sugar. There's a double team again. Double flip.
Boy, McCord looks great. Look at him. Woo!
How about just having one at a time in there of your guys,
Gibson,
huh?
Gibson brothers, look at him right there, man. Come on, you guys.
Brown Sugar with a body slam on Rick McCord. Tag made. Beautiful Bobby Eaton will be coming in. A knee to the midsection. Rick McCord back up on his feet. Right along. Eaton smacked him with a foot. Here's Roy Rogers back in after the tag. Again, Brown Sugar's knee. Waiting. Eaton slammed Roy Rogers' head into it. 2 minutes, 45 seconds gone. 2:45 into the action. Roy Rogers picked him up, body slam, but he's nailed as Bobby Eaton came in with no tag. Now there is a tag, and Bobby Eaton will be coming in.
He ain't going nowhere. Don't get excited, man. Woo! Come on,
Roy Rogers swept across the ring, rolls it down, bumps at one, two. Yep, just a one count. Just a one count is all he got.
Count by Calhoun. What is he up to referee my matches for, man?
I saw.
You see the interference
by
Sugar.
Yeah, Sugar come in with no tag. I sure did see that. That sentiment exactly from the referee. Just told Hart to shut up and sit down. Sweet Brown Sugar with a face lock on Roy Rogers. Brown Sugar with a forearm. Over to the corner. Tag on Bobby Eaton. We're getting awful close to the four-minute mark here of this match. 4 minutes. Bobby drives Roy Rogers back into the turnbuckle. Back again. That's a right fist.
There's your fist.
Bobby Eaton smacked him with a fist. Roy gets to the corner. The tag on Rick McCoy. And both of them grab it. Double arm. Drop across the knee. Backbreaker. Sugar with a cover. One, two, and three. Well, they get the win. Bobby Eaton, Sweet Brown Sugar over Roy Rogers and Rick McCord. 4 minutes, 45 seconds, the time on it.
4:45, and the First Family with a big high five in there, pick up another victory. And it was over the younger team of Roy Rogers and Rick McCord. Yeah, okay, fine. Well, that's three bouts, Davey. We got plenty of action yet to go, and we're going to be back with more of it in just one moment.
Telling them where they might be headed. Now, 20th Century Fox presents an extraordinary science fantasy adventure that will arouse this generation, telling us where we might have begun. Quest for Fire.
Now playing at Showcase in 70mm Dolby.
Wendy's introduces a new salad.
Hooray!
Wendy's new taco salad.
Hooray!
Wendy.
I, maybe Dave, from time to time, we've said an awful lot, maybe a little too much, about the confrontation that has taken place in the past between Jerry the King Lawler and Dutch Mantell. I think that anybody who would think that did not probably see any of the bouts that they have, because, brother, I'll tell you what, absolutely some of the finest, toughest wrestling action. Flying out of Oil Trough, Texas, comes the Dutchman, one tough son of a gun, boy, and he has but one thing in mind, straight ahead to the championship, and he did it. He got a win over Jerry the King Lawler, much to the surprise of a lot of people. Let's go back and relive Dutch's moment in that aspect.
History. I played all my cards, and that's what you've done too. Nothing more to say, no more ace to play. So the gods may throw a dice, their minds as cold as ice. And someone way down here, losing.
if it makes you feel sad. And I understand you've come to shake my hand. I apologize if it makes you feel bad seeing me so tense, no self-confidence. But you see, the winner takes.
Well, sir, there it was. The winner did take it all. The Dutchman himself won it. And he had that AWA title. He defended it once, successfully defended it, and then came back. Dutch, Monday night. Any night you got action with Lawler. We said we'd talked an awful lot about it, whether it's Tuesday or Saturday or what. You guys get together. I've never seen anything like it. I really want to find out about your eye, too, because that was one of the worst cuts I've ever seen.
Well, first of all, the tape you just showed was one of the greatest moments of my life. And I don't think I can ever have a moment like that again, but I'm going to have it one way or the other. Now, the AWA has seen fit to pit me against Jerry Lawler one more time, and that's all it's going to take. One more time is all I need, because I had that feeling one time, and I'm going to have it again. Now, I don't think Lawler is a better man, because I got one win and he's got one win. So, Lawler, we're going to sell it one way or the other. The superior man has not stood up to be counted yet, because that Southern belt has switched back and forth. So Lawler, it's going to be one more time around, but it's going to be the showdown. And the man that wins this is going to be the true Southern champion, and it's going to be it. Lawler, I'm going to say one thing. I'm going to come 110%, and I want you to get ready. And people, don't give up on me yet, because the Dutchman is coming back.
Well, I don't think there's anybody that even has a thought of giving up on the Dutchman. And I got to say, Dave, I think it is true. I do not think that the final verdict is in as yet, because these guys have just been so close. After Dutch had the title and the King came back, he had lots of second thoughts about it. He really, in his own mind, felt like he could beat Dutch Mantell. He wanted another shot at him, and he got it. And let me tell you, it was just typical of any of those bouts that Lawler and Mantell have had. You take a look at the action that took place. And look at the Dutchman come back. Dutch with a big elbow. The King is down. 1.5. Woo. Or, as a matter of fact, when you talk to the Dutch, serious, straight-ahead professional. Lawler, more flamboyant, multi-talented. Dutch blocks one and slaps Lawler upside the face. Referee said it was open hands. Now, let's not get into it. Buddy can't quarrel with the open hand. And besides, it's an old disqualification match. And again, the King not quite fast enough to get the Dutchman. Lawler said a lot of heavy things about Dutch, trying to get him into a return match, never dreaming that he would lose the title to him. But I have to think, having faced Dutch before, that Lawler has got to respect the toughness of this Texan. Under fire from Mantell, who follows him into the corner. And now it's getting nasty. Crowd loving it.
call is out. And Lawler really hot. And the referee trying to calm him down just a little. Big crowd on hand for this battle between Lawler and Mantell. And Dutch strikes with a foot. Again, he's after that leg of Lawler, puts him down. That the King will not take that one without one whale of a battle. And here he goes. Mantell blasted in the midsection. A big right hand on the ropes. And it looks like all the stops are out. And in the King's place, that may mean more than his pocketbook. He wheels Mantell into the turnbuckles. Mantell feeling the wrath of the King. Lawler pressing him in the corner. Dutch up off the ropes and Lawler bends him back into it. A whip into the turnbuckles. Mantell hits and stays. Mantell, no dummy himself, like it or not, slid underneath Lawler and buried a shoulder in him. Hell, oh, that last knee. He nailed Lawler right above the ear with a point of the knee. Drags Jerry out of the corner. Tags him with a right hand, and Lawler is stunned. Mantell hits the concrete. Look out! And with a running start, bombs Lawler with a right hand from outside the ring. Referee calls for a break. Dutch comes out. And again, Mantell blasts him with a right hand. Ask none, give none. All they know how to do is dish it out and take it. Backdrop on the concrete floor, and that may have done the King in. Mantell slam into the ring post by Lawler. Lawler collapses on the side of the ring to get his strength back. Mantell booming Lawler. Lawler has reached the saturation point. Nails Dutch right in the eye. Again with that big right hand. The referee checking Mantell's left eye. We told you that goose egg was right there where he hit the ring post. Lawler banging him. Referee Jerry Calhoun getting a look at that eye. Mantell says, well, I won't tell you. One, two, three, he got him. The new Southern heavyweight champion, Jerry the King Lawler, 23 minutes, 28 seconds. chance. Lawler beats Mantell, whose eye is bleeding profusely.
It just wears me out looking back at it again.
Wow.
Man, what a confrontation, I gotta tell you. These two guys are something else. I said one time or more than one time, two tough guys meeting, and boy, that's just what you got. A whirlwind out of Texas and a legend out of Memphis, Tennessee. They are something else, Lawler and Mantell. We got more action in the ring, and we'll be back to it in a moment. More action coming up here in just a moment. Before I get into the complete card at the Gardens coming up Tuesday night, let me remind you, Thursday, April 8th, Owensboro, Kentucky, at the Owensboro Sports Center. Here are a few other towns in the area I want to bring your attention to. April the 15th, Tell City, Indiana. April the 16th, Fernand, Indiana, that is. And it's going to be April the 22nd, Bardstown, Kentucky. Okay, let's take a look at Tuesday night. Rick McCord and Roy Rogers going against the Big Dream and Crazy Luke Graham. Then it'll be Eric Embry and Chief Thundercloud against Monk and the Angel. Then it'll be a six-man tag match where the entire Midnight Express, Condrey Rose and Austin, face Steve Kern, Danny Davis, and Roy Rogers. AWA Southern Tag Championship match. Eaton and Sugar will be defending against Robert Gibson and Stan Lane. And finally, that super rubber match, AWA Southern Heavyweight, Lawler and Mantell. You don't want to miss a Tuesday. Our championship wrestling program, we mentioned that we had some news about injuries. We had the opportunity to talk to Rick Gibson about a serious sternum injury that he has received. One of the guys that I'm really, really sympathetic with the condition, because here's a fellow who just is so tough that he has been hard to put away and hard to put out of the business. He has brought us as many thrills as anybody in professional wrestling. And I'm talking about that tough little nut out of Australia, superstar Bill Dundee. Billy sustained to his shoulder torn ligaments, muscles, and all of those other good things. And I don't know whether how many of you out there have had anything like ligaments torn. You have an idea about how long it can go on and plague you. The condition and the future situation of Billy with that shoulder torn up is not at this time known. It's very difficult to say. He's a tough guy, and we're looking for a great recovery from him. When it'll take place or if it will, we're not exactly sure. But I do know this, that we can look back on a lot of great moments that we received from Bill Dundee and that spectacular wrestling career of his. I'd like to share some of them with you. Champion in more than one respect. Good luck, and we're missing you right now. Hurry on back and get in shape, Billy.
Take another look at
the ring awaits. Boy, we got a single match coming up here. Stan Lane will be going against Gypsy Joe. Should be some action to see in this single match. It'll be one fall, 15-minute time limit from Romania, 224 pounds right there. Gypsy Joe going against him from Delray Beach, Florida, 218 pounds, Stan Lane. Gypsy Joe has Jimmy Hart in his corner. Referee is Jerry Calhoun. And we're underway. Lane grabs Gypsy Joe, whips him across the ring, upper arm. Lane picks him up in the air. A body slam.
Calhoun, that's a referee my matches for. Why is he refereeing my matches?
He loves to referee your matches, Jimmy.
Why does Jimmy have to be here every match?
Yeah.
Another question that comes to mind. Stan Lane, look at that move. Using the feet. Gypsy Joe off his feet, down to the mat. Gypsy Joe. Got a toe hold. He's got that knee pinned with his own lower leg. He's able to bend it sideways.
Saw Stan a little earlier in a tag match. And yeah, I hear him, Jim. Saw him a little earlier in a tag match with Robert Stan, in as much as he was going to substitute for Rick Gibson, wanted an opportunity to join up with Robert Gibson. So, in the kind of physical condition he's in, though, brother, I'll tell you, he can go, and he could probably go three more matches after this.
That's right.
Gypsy Joe, elbow to Stan Lane. We've said it about Gypsy a lot of times, Dave. This is the kind of guy that you know you're going to get hurt when you're wrestling. He is going to punish you. Now, he may get disqualified 9 out of 10 times or so. 2, 3, Stan got
him. I protest this match because in reference, Gypsy Joe shouldn't even been out here today because he had a severe case of the flu. What courage he's got! What courage he's got!
About a minute, 12 seconds to time on it.
So Stan comes up with a victory over Gypsy Joe, and we're going to go right on with action in the ring now. Is coming in, sizable team, the Monk and the Angel. We'll be facing a young team of Pat Hutchinson and Tom Maley, Dave.
All right, this one is going to be a one-fall, 15-minute time limit, too, at 387 pounds total weight from Memphis, Tennessee, both of them, Pat Hutchinson and Tom Maley. Going against them, total weight is 518 pounds from parts unknown, the Monk, and from France, the Angel. This is one fall, 15-minute time limit. Jerry Calhoun, the referee, and Jimmy Hart, again, is managing the team of the Monk and the Angel.
Boy, look at the glare off the heads of the team of the Monk and the Angel. Not a hair on their head, as a matter of fact. The Angel and the Monk, totally bald. Pat Hutchinson in with the Angel to start with. And a backdrop that put him over and down. This, if we're honest about it, would have to say is a close to a mismatch. The huge size of the Monk and the Angel compared to Hutchinson and Maley alone is one thing. Plus the fact that, oh, look at that. Man, he just fired Pat down to the ground. The experience is all on the side of the Angel and the Monk, too. So it'll be a tough, tough day for Pat Hutchinson and young Tom Maley. A couple of good scrappers, they'll give it what they got. Monk drops down with that knee, covers up Hutchinson. Two, three, he got him, did he? Yeah, he got him. That was awfully close to
Monk
kicking out.
Monk won't break the cover.
Bailey thrown out of the ring. Hart in there peeling the Monk back. There goes Hutchinson out of the ring. And the winners, the Angel and the Monk. How about time, Dave?
Time on it was 1 minute, 2 seconds. 102.
102. And the First Family's Monk and Angel pick up a victory. All righty, we'll take time out. We're going to be back in just a moment. Be right back here to Channel 3's Championship Wrestling action in just one moment. Still got some to go, and you'll want to see it, my friend. Do want to tell you, Tuesday night, Louisville Gardens, man, oh man, it's all going to come down when Jerry the King Lawler, Dutch Mantell, tag it up to determine who is going to maintain that AWA Southern Heavyweight Championship. There'll, of course, be an AWA Southern Tag Championship match with Eaton and Brown Sugar against Robert Gibson and Stan Lane. Right now, though, I want to call the King in there. He's the man that's got it around his waist, and Dutch going to be trying to take it from you.
Well, you just said the most important words, Lance, that you've spoken all week. I am the man that has the belt right now, and that is what is important. I will have the belt when I walk in the ring Tuesday night, and I plan on having it when I come out, because you see, Dutch Mantell, I heard his interview earlier, and he said that he is going to give it everything he's got. He's going to give it 110%, and he doesn't want the fans to give up on him. Well, let me ask you something, Dutch. What is it going to take for them to have to give up on you? How many times are you going to have to lose? You see, the difference between Dutch Mantell and myself is, just like he said, he is going out there, and he is struggling, and he is straining with every fiber of strength in his entire body, and he is giving it 110%, the very best he can do at all times. That's what Dutch Mantell is doing. That's what he did the last time I wrestled him. He did the absolute best that he could do. He hit me with a chair. He used a pile driver on me. He ran my head into the post. He did everything he could do, Lance, and I still won the belt. Is that right?
That is exactly
right. That is exactly right. Because you see, when Dutch Mantell is struggling and straining and going at 110%, the King is just cruising, sort of idling along at about 80%. And when I have to, I've always got that 20% to reach back there for. And if I have to, that's what I'll do Tuesday, Dutch Mantell, because they're going to give up on you, because I am the King and I am the champion and I will be the champion.
Louisville will see it. Our time is just about up here, David, and our final match, as expected, Monk and the Angel use their size and power and had no trouble with young Pat and Tom, as they gave it what they had, but as we said earlier, it's just not enough when you're going against that experience and size like that. How about a recap on all the action?
In our opener today, Steve Kern defeated the Invader. It was Stan Lane substituting for Rick Gibson, along with Robert Gibson. Stan Lane, Robert Gibson defeating Bill Owens and Ernie Kirkland. Then it was beautiful Bobby Eaton, Sweet Brown Sugar over Roy Rogers and Rick McCord. Stan Lane came back to wrestle as a single against Gypsy Joe and didn't have much trouble. About a minute, 12 seconds, Stan Lane got the win over Gypsy Joe in that single match today. And then, as Lance just said a moment ago, the Monk and the Angel going against Pat Hutchinson and Tom Maley. And that one, when you look at it, when you saw it on the card, you knew that the Monk and the Angel were, in fact, heavy favorites, very heavy favorites. And they certainly proved that to be the case. In a minute, 2 seconds, they defeated the team of Pat Hutchinson and Tom Maley with absolutely no trouble whatsoever. So Monk and the Angel, rugged tag team, something to be reckoned with around the area here in coming weeks.
You betcha, big. Over 500 pounds is a total team weight, and they're just large and hard to do business with. As a matter of fact, we didn't see him today, but another team in the First Family is that Dream Machine, Crazy Luke Graham.
Yeah. Mm.
Pardon me, that's the final. I'm getting rid of that fog so we can say goodbye here. We hope maybe you'll make it a point to catch wrestling live when it comes around your particular area, and by golly, we'll be looking forward to seeing you a lot of in the various towns. Right now, though, it's time to go. We'll be back next week for Dave Brown, Lance Russell, saying bye-bye, everybody.